Testing, testing, testing. 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, 89, 144, 233, 377. Good morning. Who's out there? Anyone alive? Looks like a few people. We have a couple hundred people registered, about a half in there already. So anyways, good morning, good afternoon, wherever you are. Hey, you know what? Two things right off the bat. I am sick as a dog today. I am beat down, tired, sick, nauseous, probably going to lose my voice, no energy, can't eat, but I'm here, okay? You can't keep me down. Can't keep a boot camper down. So I'll give you, I'll give you 120%. It's just, it may be a little less than normal. So, but anyways, thanks for being here. It's a real honor and pleasure. The other thing I'd like to tell you right off the bat is I've never written a book before, and I've never given a book tour before. So, hey, I'm an amateur at this. So, you know, please give me some leeway, but, let me tell you right off the bat that I never really intended to write a book. It's never really been a dream or aspiration for me. Although, if an opportunity like this falls into your lap, then you should consider taking it. But if you think you're going to become a multimillionaire by writing a book, I'm sorely mistaken, my friend. It's a delusion. Unless you can sell 100 million books, then all of the power to you. But it takes a lot of time and it takes a lot of energy. And I think I even picked up carpal tunnel just by writing this book. But it was important to me. Wiley, excuse me. Wow. Wiley, the publisher of this book, approached me at a Forex show. I'd just done a speech, and I was surrounded by a huge mob of people. And after that all sort of dissipated, they came up to me and said, "Have you ever thought about writing a book?" And it sort of wasn't like me writing down a manuscript and pitching it, looking to make $1 million, right? So anyways, they came to me and said, "Hey, have you ever considered writing a book?" And the raison d'etre for me, you know, the reason for being for me is to help as many Forex traders as possible. That's my mission in life, and I use FX Bootcamp to do that. I thought, you know what, I've never written a book. Maybe this is going to be another way for me to reach out and help other Forex traders. Either they're in a different part of the world that they would never come across my path otherwise, or maybe they just can't afford to become a member of FX Bootcamp for maybe they can afford $40 or $50, and that gives me an opportunity to lend a helping hand. And I tell you, I'm not going to win a Pulitzer Prize for this book. There are some spelling errors here and there. I put the I before the E here and there, and it just got past the editing. But if you can look past some minor details like that, I tell you, if you can actually see the message I'm getting across, that message is my heart, that message is my soul, and it's honestly there 100% to make a difference to your trading. I couldn't care less whether you buy this book or not. It won't affect my personal life whatsoever, but I think if you do and you read through it and you ponder it, you know what? I think it has a chance of really helping out. At least that's why I wrote it, okay? So anyways, the name of the book is The FX Bootcamp Guide to Strategic and Tactical Forex Trading. There are no trade recommendations in this presentation. There are no trade recommendations in the book. However, it does teach you technical, fundamental, and psychological aspects of trading Forex with the idea that you should have trade plans ahead of time before you pull the trigger, okay? So no matter what, before you try any of this methodology on a live account, please test it out on a demo account. Not just once or twice, but you should be able to establish a track record of success before you put a dime in the Forex market, okay? Capiche? Got about 100 people in the room. There should be a few more. My name is Wayne McDonald. I'm the chief currency coach of FXBootcamp.com. I'm also a commodities trading advisor, which is a fancy way to say the National Futures Association, the regulatory agency of the United States that regulates this market, has tested me. My fingerprints have been sent to the FBI, and I've been deemed an expert in technical and fundamental analysis for Forex and for commodities and futures and options. options and all these types of things. And it gives me the license, per se, to advise professional investors such as hedge funds. And I guess on my business card I could put author as well, but enough titles already, huh? The name of my company is fxbootcamp.com. It's a live training organization. We teach people how to trade Forex live in real time while the market's moving. We don't talk about what happened yesterday. We talk about what's going to happen in the next, 4 minutes to 4 days, 4 weeks. We teach scalping, spot trading, swing trading, position trading, carry trading, everything that you need. And it is 12 hours a day. Every single trading day, 12 hours on, 12 hours off. Start at pre-London, go to the noon New York time. There it is. There's the book. It's available on Amazon.com and about 158 million other websites that sell the book, and it's a top seller. I think today it's number two. It's been as high as number one, and there are hundreds of Forex books, so it's a real honor. Obviously, your loyalty. Has really helped this book, so I really appreciate that. Okay, but it is available out there, and the link is on this website as well. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the history of the book. I mean, I want you to understand that there's humanity in this book. Okay, you guys following me? Oh yeah, you like that phone number? Yeah, notice I was a Fibonacci. Okay, I just want to make sure. There's a lot of people here, okay? You might have a lot of questions. Here's my game plan here. I'm going to tell you how the book started, then we're just going to peek through at different parts of the book, and I'll talk about it and give you sort of a taste of what's in there. And and then I thought I'd actually read from the book. I mean, I don't know what to do on this tour, so I thought I'd give you an overview, then give you a sneak peek, and then I'll read some of my favorite passages, and you'll get a feel for me, my writing style, what's in the book, and whether you think it could help you or not. Okay, and then I'll answer some questions as well. But I launched the book at the Forex Trading Expo in Las Vegas. It's the largest Forex conference in the world. I sponsored the show, and here's the thing. If there's this little birdie in the back of your mind saying, you know, you don't want to buy this book because you think it's going to make me become rich, you know, like I'm in it for the money. Let me tell you, if I sold a bajillion amount of books, I'll never recover the amount of money I spent launching the book. So I actually launched the book by sponsoring the Forex Trading Expo, and I bought every single Forex trader there, thousands of traders, a free drink. Okay? So there's no way. I'm going to lose money on this book. Okay? Right out there, that's for you to know and for you to trust. Okay? This is what I did, bought everyone a drink, we had a lot of fun. This was September 12th, was the day it launched, and they sold copies at the show, and bought everyone a drink, and I'm telling you, we had a lot of fun, and besides helping people, I think this is, I want people to have fun when they're trading, and I think you're going to find that it's a very unique book, because you're going to get 100% of Wayne McDonald in it. Love me or hate me, you're going to get my personality in this book. And if you've come to any of my webinars, you're going to hear my voice as I tell these stories and teach you everything that I've learned, blood, sweat, and tears. But it's launched at the Forex Trading Expo. There's the cups. I actually printed out custom cups. And so you can imagine about, 2,500 Forex traders in Las Vegas standing around drinking beer and wine out of camouflage cups with the picture of the book on it. And to get the drink, they had to go up to a bartender. And I got this crazy idea. They got one free drink each, and they had to hand in a drink ticket, and one part had to go to the bartender, right? So this was perforated, and they ripped off the ticket and gave that free drink part, because it says join FX Bootcamp for a free drink. So they ripped off the free drink part, gave it to the bartender, and they were left now with the other part of the drink ticket, which was exactly the correct size for a large bookmark. It was actually a bookmark. The drink ticket was a bookmark, so you can put it in the book. So anyways, I'm having fun with it. I mean, that's the name of the day, name of the game. Just have that fun. And that's me at the conference. As it was launching, the book came out, and that was pretty much the first time anyone, including myself, actually saw the book, because they shipped the books to the show. Never seen them until I got to the show. Isn't that super sweet? And this is Traders Press. They go to all the financial conferences around the United States, and all they do is sell books. It's like a traveling bookstore. They had all these other books there, and I came to them at the end, and I said, hey, how'd they sell? Did you sell any? And they're like, we sold more of your book than all the other books combined and then some. And they were very happy. And this is me standing with Traders Press, and I signed books and did all that kind of stuff. So it's fun. I'm just showing you the humanity here. There's a real person behind this. I spent more than 6 months actually writing the book and developed carpal tunnel syndrome. My wrist, my elbow, and my shoulder still hurts, okay? So effort went into it. That's all I'm trying to say. A real person wrote the book, but even more importantly, a real person went through the learning experience to come up with the methodology. And I failed so much at Forex that eventually I got better through, I don't know, osmosis or something. But I explain exactly how and how I improved and what I did and to succeed and how I avoided failure. Everything's in this book. Okay, everything is in this book. So anyways, there's the cover, and a couple of quotes right off the back. Most importantly here, this is from the CEO of FX Street, Francesc. Wayne McDonald is the most popular Forex speaker on our website. His live training and education draws large crowds of traders because he can explain complex Forex trading concepts in a common language that anyone can understand. This book does the same. I highly recommend it. Another quote from the founder of that Forex Trading Expo, the largest Forex conference in the world. If you're looking for specific strategies and methods for making money with currency trading, you need to start reading this book today. Wayne knows from experience what it takes to succeed in the Forex markets. He provides step-by-step instructions and explains in common language what to look for in charts and in the news to find profitable trades immediately. Don't make a single Forex trade until you read this book. Tim Berkman, founder of the Forex Trading Expo. So yeah, it covers a lot of things. This book. It was also Book of the Month on MoneyShow.com, and they reviewed the book. And it was a very extensive, very long review. But bottom line says, overall, this is one of the better FX books I've read in some time, and one I can wholeheartedly recommend. By the way, Tom, who reviewed the book, is a very seasoned trader and an author himself. The book is well worth the time and money for both the novice and experienced traders. If you have been trading for some time and are not satisfied with your performance, the book may help you fine-tune your trading. I would bet that the book would be a good reread in future years. See, the bottom line is it's not really a beginner's book. Okay, it's sort of like an intermediate book, I guess is the way to look at it. I don't tell you what a pip is, or I don't think I explain in great detail, you know, the mathematical formulas for a moving average. I assume that you've maybe tinkered around for a few months, and you know enough to follow this. So it assumes that you know a little bit, and then it goes from there to fundamental analysis and beyond. Okay. Okay, hope you guys are still following me, and I apologize again for my voice being so harsh. I am sick as a dog. Okay, so let's start with the table of contents. There's a lot of stuff in this book. Here's the logic. Let me share the logic of how I broke it down. Okay, the number one thing you got to start with is basic training, and that's what I did here. So I do go into how to use moving averages, Bollinger Bands, and such, support and resistance, Fibonacci retracements, extensions, very important stuff, okay? Basic training, it's truly the boot camp, the stuff you need to know so you can understand the rest of the book, okay? And that's, look at that, that's 34 pages right off the bat. Then part two, strategic analysis. Remember, this book is strategic and tactical Forex trading. So now, once you have sort of the common language that you've learned through basic training, then we go right into the strategy, okay? And what's interesting is I talk and teach about central banking policy, open market operations, interest rates, inflation, okay? How this affects values of currencies and why. Okay, isn't that interesting? Right off the bat, once you get to know sort of the basics of your charts, boom, let's move into why the currency markets exist and how they function. Now, in my humble opinion, technical analysis puts you in and takes you out of trades, but they do not create the trades. Okay, what moves money or what changes the value of currencies? If you're a currency trader, you need the values to change. You need them to move up and down. What actually changes the value of currencies is central banking policy and economic decisions made by central bankers around the world. And I go right into that in great detail, but I explain it in a way, I swear to you, you're going to understand. And pretty soon you're going to be an expert in things like open market committee operations and inflation and interest rates. Okay, and I talk here, as you can see, money magnets, what this creates, okay, and why values, why currency values change. Isn't that interesting? Why the values change, that's very important to me, not just how, but the why. And my goal here is to teach you to understand really why the whole system works the way it does. Okay, not memorizing a bunch of formulas, okay? Then I go into carry trades, and I use an example of how to get a free house from Forex and all that kind of stuff. And then that goes deeply into Forex economics and the Federal Reserve System here in the United States. So yeah, I dive right into the Fed and central banking policy in the United States. And then I move into commodities, talking about gold, oil, and equities and stuff like that to teach you how things like the S&P 500, the FTSE, the DAX affect currency trading, how gold and oil affects currency trading. Because again, I see that as part of the fundamentals. Now, it is technically intermarket analysis, but I teach you how, not just to memorize sort of if this goes up, that goes down, but how they truly affect valuations of currencies, how and why, so that you understand. Okay, again, you understand global money flow. All right? And then here's how, remember, this book is designed not just to give you the information, but to teach you how to become a better trader. That may be what really differentiates this book from all the others. There is a big chunk of this book focused not on just the, you know, the information, but how you personally will become a better Forex trader. And so I go into chapter 7 specifically talking about being a greenback guru and how you can start developing positive trading habits and improving your trading skills by specifically focusing on the USD. And then with that, you're going to need to know things like the currency correlation coefficients and trading currency correlations and trading baskets of currencies based on the US dollar, and why, you know, I think I give like 5 or 6 reasons why it's important to focus on the dollar. So, you know, for example, it's a reserve currency of the world, and maybe you don't know what the reserve currency means and what status it gets. Well, then it talks all about that. Okay, part 3, rules of engagement. Okay, rules of engagement. This is where I go through the specific methodology, the specific technical analysis methodology for entering and exiting a trade, and I spend, what is that, 50 pages going through it. Okay, how to analyze the market, how to analyze price, how to use global money flow to understand the likely trend or direction a currency pair is going to take, and then how to use things like, oh, I don't know, support and resistance, things like Fibonacci retracements and extensions, things like pivot point analysis. Okay? Very, very interesting. But more importantly, check this out. Then I go into things like fear of loss, fear of profit, limit orders, the bootcamp credo, limits for loss, limits for profit. More tactics for entering and exiting trades. Your mind's eye. Do you have the guts? Second chances in Forex. Wow. So I'm always sort of getting you ready for what's coming up. Okay? Which is the psychological stuff. So I go right into it, sort of, you know, how to develop a strategy in Forex through the rules of engagement. And then I start to teach you right away how to deal with, your own personal side, because how many times do you see a trade set up, it's perfect, you know it, and you still can't do it. And then the next one is a crappy one, and you take that one. Well, so as soon as I throw out the methodology, I want to teach you how to deal with yourself, okay? Even though that's not the part of the book, I'm already preparing to deal with that little that insecurity that you might have as a new trader. And I'll go into this, and I'll even read from it later. Then part four is tactical planning. This is how to pull the trigger, my friend. How to pull the trigger. Not just the strategy, okay? The strategy, but how to actually pull the trigger and hit your targets. That's what it's all about. Very specifics. Reversal patterns, continuation patterns, trending situations, floors and ceilings, over and out, conservative news, trades. You know what? I teach you two different ways to scalp news. Okay? Specific methodology, specifically on how to scalp the news. Now, I teach you how to spot trade, teach you how to carry trade, teach you how to position trade and understand why all these things work, but even scalping using 1 minute trade setups post news. Okay? It's very, very specific here. Okay? There's my methodology, there's my strategy, there's my tactics, and everything you need to know to understand my logic, and everything you need to understand the technical analysis, okay? But where most books fail in the Forex world is how to implement it personally, how to become a better trader. And that's what the rest of the book is. Part five, psychological warfare. And this isn't against the enemy, my friend. This is against you, mano y mano, how you can personally help yourself become a better trader. All right? Isn't that cool? So it goes right into going mental and our common thread, and how to deal with the challenges that you're going to face as you move toward becoming a professional, successful, profitable trader. Understand yourself, understand your trades. Look at all these subtitles, okay? And what this does is teach you how, first of all, by throwing my heart and soul out onto the table, laying down the cards and showing you all the different ways I personally screwed up, but how I learned to improve and adapt, and actually how I personally changed my behavior to grow as a Forex trader. Okay? Interesting, I hope. Then I go into things like how to have a 3-year business plan for your trading, how to budget your trading, and then how to sharpen and hone your skills to become a better trader. But to do that, you're going to have to identify your own personal strengths and weaknesses as a trader and actively refine these things. Cut out your weaknesses and refine and hone in on your strengths and get better and better and better. And by doing so, what you'll find is you'll start cutting out the mediocre trades that you're probably breaking even on if you looked at the last 90 days of your trading and then looked at all your mediocre break-even trades. You could cut all that out, and then you probably have 3 or 4 or 5 really stupid trades. If we cut that out, you're probably already a profitable trader, except you're dragging your profits down. And I can teach you how to cut all that out, trade less, and perhaps even make more money, okay? But it's not just like following rules that will do that. You have to go through a maturity process, and I explain how I did that, okay? You're going to have an epiphany, an aha moment. You're going to need to work your butt off harder than you've ever worked your butt off before to even have a chance. But at least now you don't have to spend all your time trying to figure out what's happening. Okay? All right? Because I failed and failed and failed and failed and then found something that worked. Then failed and failed and failed and failed and failed and found something else that worked. And then failed and failed and failed and failed and failed and found something else that worked. And it takes, if you're trying to figure out everything from scratch yourself, guess what? Half the time you don't know what's working and what's not working. Okay, I've gone through all that, so I can sort of lay the path out there. I've been there for you. I don't have a crystal ball or a magic formula, but I can teach you how to become a patient, disciplined trader, okay, using a conservative focus. You can become your own trader. You're not going to become another Wayne McDonald, but this book will teach you how you can refine your trading. It will, okay? Let me give you a sneak peek now. Let's move to the next part of the presentation here. Here's me going over things like the producer price index, CPI, and for each of these, I go through during the in the part of the book that I go through fundamental analysis. I teach you what all the different major economic reports mean, why they're important. Then I give you historic data. So, for example, you know, here's every single here's currency pairs like I think they're Kiwi dollar, U.S. Euro dollar, USD, Swiss franc, pound, yen, euro yen, all the different major pairs that you're probably trading and major crosses that you're trading. And it shows you over the last 24 months the average move that these economic reports such as PPI, CPI, GDP actually had created in the move in the market. So over the last 24 months you might find that for CPI maybe the pound dollar moves 86 pips and the euro dollar moves 56 pips and the pound yen moves 128 pips. And you'll know that using historic data. And then it goes through and I show you month after month after month so if this was CPI, it'll actually go through and show you every month for the last for 2 years what the industry expected out of that economic report numbers wise, what the actual results were for, let's say, May 16th CPI 2006, what was expected, what the differential was, and how much the market actually moved high, low, and range. And I do this for every single major economic news report in the United States, not just giving you the what it means or why it's important, but the actual hardcore numbers over the last 24 months of those reports coming out and how much each of those moved every specific currency pair. Woo! And later in the book, I specifically teach you how to scalp that news too. All right? Come on, that's got to be good. That's got to give you the juice. Here's another part in basic training. Okay, here's part of the book on basic training. How to use MACD. Here's three different ways to use MACD, and then I go through and give you examples of how to use each. Now, some of the criticisms that I got on this book is that it was poorly edited. But you know what? I'm a writer. Actually, no, that's stupid. I shouldn't have said that. I'm a currency trader. I spent 6 months writing the book, and then I handed it over to the publisher, the world's largest publisher of financial books. Okay, they have a staff, they have editors, they have copywriters. Someone should have caught my spelling mistakes. I'm sorry. Okay, but I'm a trader first and foremost, and I did the best I can, pouring my heart and soul out. But I apologize if an I is before an E. I hope you can get past that. And then the other criticism that I get on this book is it's hard to read the charts. Okay, so let me zoom in and you can see for yourself. That's what a chart looks like. You know, I can't give you color. Come on, a book would be $4,000. It's not even my decision. It's not even my book. It's Wiley's book. I wrote it. I gave him the charts in color. Okay. And they're the ones that publish the size of the charts. They're not bad. You know, me personally, I can read it and I can totally understand. But if you're not used to the methodology, then I could see, okay? I can see how it might be tricky. But there's an example of MACD divergence. Okay, seems like it's fairly easy to read. Here's another part of the book. I grabbed a bunch of charts so you can see easy things, complicated things. Okay, I think I zoom in on this. So here's one me doing a second chance trade. This is where you identify support and resistance. Okay, you stay out. There's a break. It pulls back, gives you a second chance, and then you short here. Okay, and that's on page 120. You know, that's not that difficult to read, is it? I mean, I'm not poo-pooing on the feedback. I mean, if you find it difficult to read, I apologize. But this is an actual image from the actual book. I don't find it that bad, but I understand what you're saying, okay? I understand, but hopefully it's, I don't know, hopefully it's good enough. You know, I mean, that's the best it can be, and if it's still difficult, I'm sorry. But I still believe, I honestly believe you can still get the actual message. And if you're trying to figure out, like, what is that little moving average, you're missing the actual point. Okay? But anyways, I apologize. But if I go back, there's things like, look, can you see the double top? And then there, I clearly point to the double top. And this is out of technical analysis, and this is out of rules of engagement. So these are from different parts of the book. But I just want to throw out there, I'm not hiding anything, so I'm going to throw the good, the bad, and the ugly out there, okay? Boy, I'm running out of time. I gotta move. Okay, here's a couple other parts of the book: fundamental analysis, basic training stuff. Here's the formula for pivot points, and I teach you extensively how to use pivot points and in uptrends, downtrends, side trends, inside days, all these things. And there's the formula, and talk about fundamentals. Here's the part under fundamental analysis, and there's the FX Street calendar that I recommend using. So, right on. I mean, there's a lot of different things in here. Okay. Lots of different things go into this book. Also, some of the other things that I cover in here that you'll never find in another Forex book is how to come up with a three-year plan. Three-year plan, so you have a long-term view of your trading, and I discuss it at great lengths. I teach you how to manage your budget and why that's important. And then the other thing that I want to discuss here is a concept that I introduce in the book here should make a difference. And I throw my cards on the table and I wear my heart on my sleeve in this book, and I tell you the struggles and strife that I personally went through trying to figure out Forex. And it was hard, man. It's still hard, but it was really hard. And one of the things I did, and I discuss it in great lengths in this book, is how I developed a personal mentor. And what I call this mythical person is the perfect trader, the mythical perfect trader. And I'll show you how to use that in there, where I actually came up and created a checklist of what I thought the perfect trader would be. Then I went on for a while just trying to be that perfect trader, trying to follow the things as if the perfect trader was mentoring me, all right? And my goal was to fake it till I make it, to just keep pretending, even though I wasn't the perfect trader, just keep trying and pretending I'm the perfect trader. One day, I hope to wake up and realize I forgot that I was pretending. And I'm just doing everything on that checklist. Every characteristic I thought the perfect trader would have, I just happened to be doing because I was faking it. And then one day I had forgot I was faking it, and I just was it, or at least closer. The goal was to strive to improve, strive to challenge myself, and strive to work harder than anybody else. And I'll go into that. Okay? So let's move on to the next phase, and let me actually read from the book. But you guys following me here? We got about 11 and a half minutes left. I looked at, like 10 things I'd love to read, okay, from this book. Okay? Yeah, if the charts are difficult to read, I do so much stuff publicly for free. You can track me down. You'll learn it, okay? Okay, let me actually read from a little bit from the actual preface of the book. Have you ever bought a Forex book and it was sort of like mostly rah, 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 get you excited sort of a book? Something like that. Yeah, you know what? I'm not a rah-rah guy, I'm a realist, okay? I worked really hard to become successful at Forex, so I know what it's going to take you, okay? And most people are going to be really challenged by this. This is out of the preface. The first thing I say in the book, okay? I'm just going to read from a paragraph here. FX Bootcamp's Guide to Strategic and Tactical Forex Trading will guide you on the path from failure to success. However, the journey is yours to take. The question is, do you have the guts to work your butt off and get really good at Forex trading? Not clear enough? How about this? I believe that 90% of amateur traders fail, not because they lack an understanding of the market, because they are not willing or able to do the work required to become an amazing trader. In Forex trading, patience and discipline are just as important as technical and fundamental analysis. Are you willing to give yourself enough time to learn how to trade? Are you willing to do the work? Will you do whatever it takes to succeed? This book will help you develop positive trading habits and give you lifelong trading skills. It's not a silly magic system of the moment. This book will not do the work for you, but it will teach you how to stay out of a lot of bad trades, and you will learn how to wait for better trades. In fact, this book will teach you how to think for yourself and trade successfully on your own. All right, is that in your face or not? Is that pure, raw honesty, or is that fluff? I'm telling you, in the first, it's not even page one yet, I'm kicking you in the butt. 90% fail because they don't have the guts to do the work. They're looking for a get-rich-quick scheme, and honey, it ain't Forex, okay? So I'm going to randomly just grab stuff out of the book here. I'm going to keep reading, okay? And you're going to get a sense of what's in the book, and you're going to get a sense of my personality. This is chapter 3, How to Gather Market Intelligence to Formulate a Trading Strategy. Isn't that awesome? Let's talk about this. Strategy is not employed in the trenches. It's not hand-to-hand combat. It is not the foot soldier peering through a sight. It is not the field officer scanning the terrain with his binoculars. It is a four-star general reviewing images from the U-2 reconnaissance plane and spy satellites away from the battlefield. In Forex, strategy does not put you into a trade. However, it is your general bias for a currency or currency pair. It helps you pick direction for the market. Strategy can last a very long time, many months and often even years. Like a battle commander who uses information to coordinate a cohesive strategy for his troops, a Forex trader must use information to formulate a strategy for making trades. To formulate a strategy in war, analysis of the enemy's strengths and weaknesses, such as its abilities to resupply its forces or defend its fortifications, is necessary. The best way to do this is to get constant data from the field. Snapshots from high altitude give you telling signs, but they are only clues. You may see, for example, a convoy of trucks, but you will not know what they are carrying inside them. Is it weapons of mass destruction? Troop reinforcements, medical supplies, or civilian refugees. As a Forex trader, you can review all known information to formulate a strategy. You can also get snapshots from a distance in the form of economic data released on an ongoing basis from all the major economies around the world. These data reports are clues to economic strengths and weaknesses. Okay? And then I go on to inflation sensation, teach you how inflation and interest rates, currency demand equal higher valuations. So I'm getting you pumped right off the bat why you need to understand fundamental analysis and economic reports. Guess what I do next? I take you through every single major U.S. economic report, and like I showed you, what it means, why it's important to you as a Forex trader, and all the historic data per currency pair and per release going back 2 years. Come on, that's gotta jazz you. That's gotta jazz you. I'm pumped and I'm sick as a dog and I love this stuff. So if you just don't get fundamental analysis, you gotta get the book, bro. Gotta get on the clue train. All right, I'm moving to a different part of the book. How about the 3 second rule? If you make a winning trade, you have 3 seconds to cheer, jump around your office, ring a bell, high-five your cat, and kiss your dog while all the angels in heaven share tears of joy at the beautiful trade you made. Your trading greatness is a shining light in a world of darkness. You are an inspiration to all traders around the world. When your 3 seconds are up, sit down, shut up, and get ready for the next trade. If you make a losing trade, you have 3 seconds to pound your fist, throw your mouse, kick your chair, drop your head in shame, and cry me a river. When your 3 seconds are up, sit down, shut up, and get ready for the next trade. Winning and losing trades are both inevitable in Forex. You cannot take either of them personally. You win some, you lose some. That's the way it goes. Each trade should not be that big of a deal to your overall trading career or trading account. However, if you make a stupid trade, such as chasing price or jumping in late, then you deserve the agony of entering the stupid trade into your journal. Remember it, and don't do it again. Learn. Okay? There's your 3 second rule. And I teach you how to use journals, so that's what it's talking about. I teach you how to not chase price, and that's in the book. Okay? And here's the big thing. Did you get the message there? Any any given trade or even trading day should not be that important to you, okay? You shouldn't have a trade that's so bad that it's important, okay? If you make one trade or have a bad trading day and you lose so much money that that you're actually upset about it, you're way over leveraged, my friend, and you got way too much money on your trades. Boy, how much more time do I have? Oh man, I got so much more I'd like to read. Trading discipline, I guess I'm not going to have time for that. I think I only got 2 more minutes. I have a section on premature exiting. No, there's no pill for that, my friend. But if you have trouble where you get in a good trade and then you exit and too early and it goes on and on and on and you missed it, you just got out too early, I have a quick fix for that. Okay, I got 5 minutes left. So if that's you, the premature exiter, there's a strategy in there to get better. Like I showed you in the image back there when I was taking you through different parts of the book, I showed you that there's a second chance in Forex, and I'd give you specific strategies on how to do that through role reversals. Okay, now a big chunk of the book is focused on planning your trades and trade planning. Let me read just briefly about how to illustrate an example of why this is important. It's called Take the High Ground. In war, it is best to take the high ground and build your fortifications. After you have done this, all you have to do is wait for the enemy to attack you. If they do, you will certainly have the upper hand. If the enemy does not attack you, do not meet them on a level playing field where you do not have a tactical advantage. If the enemy does not fall for your trap, don't attack. If they leave, you will simply leave too and set another trap somewhere else. This means your chance of survival is much higher. If you are not looking for a fight. Your primary goal is to simply to survive. If you are attacked, you will want the best odds of surviving. If you are not attacked, then you automatically survive as you avoided confirmation. And if you ever read The Art of War, it talks about that. Like that's a very honorable thing to do as a general. What I'm saying is you do not control the market, but you do control your trading. You can set up a trade plan, sit there and wait for it to come to fruition. If it does, you pull the trigger. If you don't, you walk and you don't lose any money when you're wrong. Or if you do, you learn very quickly because your analysis set the trade up, and if it goes and then comes back and knocks you out, at least you lost hardly anything because you fought your battles on your own terms, not on the enemy's terms, okay? You cannot control the market, but you can hopefully control your behavior. If not, then you need this book like yesterday. Okay, so I was going to read about the Born to Trade, the perfect trader, my invisible imaginary mentor. Some of the things on the list that I created for my perfect trader was to keep a trade journal, to review my trades, to understand my strengths and weaknesses, to work on specific trading goals, to manage my risk, to plan my trading business, to practice conservative, repeatable trading, and commit 100% or walk away from a trade. Okay, I go into a great deal into this. Okay, things like having a 3-year trading plan. Can you even imagine having a business plan for your trading career that goes out every single day for 3 years in advance? I show you how, I show you why, so that maybe you can challenge yourself to do it. Okay? Here's how I'd like to end it. Page 98, Natural Born Traders. Was I a natural born trader? Hardly. I had the worst instincts and my gut feeling was always wrong. I think I was born the world's worst trader. However, my trade journal improved my trading right away. I documented every trade in my journal. I would grab a screenshot of my trade and enter it into the journal, which was an Excel spreadsheet. After entering all my financial data, I would insert long and detailed notes of why and how I made the trade. This forced me to think about it. Why did I take the trade? What justified the risk? Why did I get out? This allowed me to relive each of my trades. Remember, your mind does not know the difference between your last trade and your current trade. To your mind, both are real and in the moment. Just thinking about the details of my trade was like making the trade all over again. My trade journal doubled my trade experience instantly. I really needed this experience as well. I need to get past my lousy feeling for the market. I needed more control, and I achieved this by planning my trades. Then, by reviewing my trades, I learned from each of my wins and each of my losses. The trade journal became the check and balance. I found that I wasn't certain about if I wasn't certain about the trade setup, I didn't make the trade because I didn't want to have to put it into my trade journal. It was like looking over my own shoulder. So I was mentored by the perfect trader, the imaginary person that I invented, and then suddenly I was mentoring myself, looking over my own shoulder with the use of not only technical and fundamental analysis and the psychology of the stuff that I'm discussing here, but by doing the hard work of documenting every trade journal so that I relived every single trade over and over and over to identify my own personal strengths and weaknesses. And by the way, this took so much work that the work itself started me, like I say here, I started to wimp out on the mediocre trades I knew that were probably not good to begin with, and so I started trading less, and my profits improved. Okay, I traded less, I worked more, I traded less, and my profits improved. But simply by cutting out the stupid trades and the mediocre trades, I was just left with the better trade setups, and then I moved forward for the next few years, getting better and better at what I knew was sound technical and fundamental analysis. There is the book tour. Thank you, everyone, for attending. I appreciate it. Several hundred people registered. Lots and lots of people attended this presentation. Exactly 4 to 5 minutes. So anyways, real honor and pleasure to have you here. And I hope you, if you decide to purchase the book, I hope you enjoy it. Okay, once again, my name is Wayne McDonald. Whew. A lot of information. Wow. So, and I'm sorry I'm sick as a dog, guys, but hopefully you found it beneficial, and maybe you can spare $40 and buy the book and help yourself. Whatever. Okay, but if you do, it'll make a difference. If you don't, it doesn't make a difference to me. So anyways, take care of yourself. Happy pipping. Happy pipping. Peace on earth. Take care of yourself. Cheers.